We're reading Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 3, Chapter Number 5, Text Number
27.
Tato Abhavan Mahatattvam Avyaktat Kala Choditat Vigyan Atma Vigyan At Atma Vigyan Atma Atma Deha Stam Vishvam Vyanjams Tato Nudha. Tato Bhavan Mahatadvam. Tato Bhavan Mahatadvam. Avyaktat Kalachoditat. Avyaktat Kalachoditat. Vigyan at Atma Dehastam. Vigyan Atma Atma Dehastam. Vishwam Vyanjam stato nudha. Vishvam janjam tato nudam. Tato bhavan mahatavam. Avyaktat kalachoditat. Vidyan atmatma dehastam. Vishvam vyanjam stato nudha. Tato bhavan mahatattvam. Avyaktat kalachoditat. Vigyan at atma dehastam. Vishvam vyanjam stato nudha.
Came into existence.
Mahat
Supreme. Tattvam. Samtoto. Avyakta. From the unmanifested. Kalachodita. By the interaction of time. Vijnana Atma. Unalloyed goodness. Atma Deha Stam. Situated on the bodily self. Vishwam. Complete universe. Vyanjan. Manifesting. Tamanuda. The Supreme Light. Translation. Thereafter, influenced by the interactions of eternal time, the supreme sum total of matter, called the Mahatattva, became manifested. And in this Mahatattva, the unalloyed goodness, the Supreme Lord, sowed the seeds of universal manifestation out of his own body.
译文, 那之后, 由于永恒时间互动的影响, 物质能量总体展示了, 至善的至尊主, 把众多宇宙展示的种子, 排出他的体外。
Purport. In due course of time, the impregnated material energy was manifested first as the total material ingredients.
要指在适当的时候，已经受孕的物质能量，首先展示为包含全部物质元素在内的物质能量总体。
Everything takes its own time to fructify, and therefore the word kalachoditat, influenced by time, is used herein.
万事万物都需要经过一段时间才能达到成熟，因此这节诗里用了梵文，在时间的作用下一句，kalachoditat.
The Mahatattva is a total consciousness, because a portion of it is represented in everyone as the intellect.
物质能量总体是意识的总和，因为其中有一部分体现为众生各自具有的智力。
The Mahatattva is directly connected with the Supreme Consciousness of the Supreme Being, but still it appears as matter.
物质总体虽然与至尊者的至尊意识相通，
但还是具有物质的外貌。The Mahatattva, or shadow of pure consciousness, is the germinating place of all creation.
物质能量总体这一纯粹意识的影子，是孕育整个创造的土壤。It
is pure goodness with a slight addition of the material mode of passion. And therefore, activity is generated from this point.
它是纯粹善良属性掺杂了一些物质激情属性的产物，因此活动便产生了。
Om Abhyanatimarantasya Gyananjana Shalataya Chaksurunilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Vaivacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha. Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. So Maharaj Parikshit wanted to know how the creation took place. He inquired from Sukadeva Goswami.
Parikshit Maharaj 想知道这个创造是如何发生的, 因此他在这里询问 Sukadeva Goswami.
And Sukadeva Goswami tells about how the same question was asked by Vidura to Maitreya.
然后这个Sukadeva Goswami 解释说, 维多拉向圣人Maitreya也询问了同样的问题。
So we're hearing Maitreya explain about the process of creation.
所以我们现在在这里聆听Maitreya在解释创造的过程。
And he's explaining that everything takes place in the course of time.
他在这里说到，所有的一切都是随着时间的进展而发生的。Time
is in the material world.
时间在物质世界里运作。In
the spiritual world, there's no time as such, but there's the impression of time, but without real time. Time is there, but it's time in the spiritual world, people feel like there's time, but actually there's no time.
在灵性世界里是没有时间的影响的，即便是那里的人们会感觉到有时间，但是实际上那个不是真正的时间。在灵性世界里是没有时间运作的。Because
time decays everything.
因为时间会让所有的一切变得衰退。
The material, everything in the material world is a temporary manifestation. It appears for some time, it stays, and then it breaks down and disappears. The material body of the living entities go through different stages of life.
物质生物体的这个物质身体会经历不同的阶段。
Take birth, first of all take birth and then begin to grow and then maintain.
首先出生然后成长停留一段时间。
And then maybe produce some byproducts.
然后也许会产生一些副产品。
And then dwindle and die.
然后变得衰退最后死亡。
And everything in the material world goes through these different stages. We should understand that material energy is eternal. But sometimes it's manifest and sometimes it's not. Just like our material body.
就好像我们的物质身体。It's
made up of the elements of earth, water, fire, air, and ether.
它是由土、水、火、空气、以太这些物质元素构成的。That's
a gross body.
就是粗糙的身体。And
then we have the subtle body.
除此之外，我们还有精微的身体。The
mind, the intellect, and the ego.
心意、智性、杂我构成精微的躯体。And
here we're told today that the intellect is the Mahatattva. No, come on. In the purport, they don't say Mahatattva. They
don't.
Use it now. You need to use Anjao Tamadayalji.
Okay. 这个要字里面说到，这个众生的智力，他们是物质能量总体当中的一部分。
In the English, they use the Sanskrit term, but in the Chinese, they put it into some. They try to explain the Mahatattva with some Chinese words.
在梵文之中呢，他们用的是这个梵文字Mahatattva，但是翻译成中文的时候，他们用这个物质能量总体这个词汇来解释Mahatattva。
不是能量，众生，不是能量，沙。 Total. So that's the Mahatattva is a manifestation of all the material elements.
So this
Before the Mahatattva appears, it is as pradhan, it's just simply pradhan, it's not manifesting. But when it's manifesting, then the creation begins.
但是当它展示出来的时候，这个创造就发生了。And
you have this Mahatattva is all the different elements of material nature mixed together.
在这个物质能量总体中，所有的物质元素都混合的在一起。Just
like if you go to India, they often cook something called khichdi.
比方说，如果你去印度的话，那印度人有时会做一种叫做kachori的食物。
No, not kachori. 不是 kachori. Kachori 是另外一个东西。 Khichdi.
Khichdi.
We call it chomrendadakan.
Khichdi.
The poor man's feast.
我们把它称之为是穷人的大餐。
The poor man's feast.
What,
poor people with not much money, you know, they will cook khichdi. Often in the temples, at breakfast, they will serve khichdi.
Khichdi.
So khichdi is a mixture. They will put rice, and dal, and vegetables, the green leafy vegetables, and potato, and carrot, and different, they'll mix everything in there.
Khichdi 它是一种混合物，里面有就是各种东西，有大米，有豆，有土豆，有胡萝卜，有绿叶菜，还有其他的蔬菜等等。
It's all there in the khichdi.
这些所有不同的食材都混合在这个khichdi里面。
好像中国，我们说粥啊，就比方说中国的粥。泰州啊，so in India they make khichdi. They put dal in it. So the dal gives protein. It's very healthy.
所以这个印度人呢，他们就做这种 khichdi， 在这个里面呢，他们会放豆，这个豆它是非常有营养的，能够。
Yeah, and especially in the very hot weather, it's very nice to take khichdi with a little yogurt.
尤其是在这个天气热一点的时候呢，拌着那个酥油吃khichdi是非常好的。加一点酸奶。
Then makes it gives it more taste.
加一点酸奶在里面，会让它变得更美味。But
in the hot weather, you take some khichdi with a little yogurt. It's very good.
就在天气比较热的时候，你拌着那个酸奶吃khichdi是非常好的。So
if you take dal, you don't need meat. You see, all these people say, "Oh, no protein. Oh, you have to eat meat. No protein." But if you take dal, you don't need meat.
如果你吃豆类的话，那你是不需要吃肉的。那就有些人会问，你们不吃肉，那你们从哪里得到营养呢？实际上，如果你们吃豆的话，那个营养，豆里面是有营养的。And
you'll see wherever there's the Indian store selling groceries, they will sell dal.
就如果你们去到那个印度的杂货店里面去看的话，一般他们都会有出售这种豆类。豆。
Because they have to have that 豆汤，他们的豆汤特别重要，有营养，有。The dal has protein. It gives energy. It's very important in the diet.
所以这个豆类里面它非常的有营养，它能够提供能量，所以吃豆类是很重要的。
So, pradhan is unmet, nothing, you can't see anything, it's not manifest.
Pradhan 是一种未展示的状态，是什么都看不见的。
But then the pradhan, when it becomes mahatattva, then it appears. The mahatattva is the kitchen, everything is all the elements of the material nature.
但是 Pradhan 一旦变成这个 Mahatattva 变成这个物质能量实体的时候呢，它就开始展示出来，就好比这个 Khichuri 它在里面混合着所有的这些原料。
And here Prabhupada tells us this Mahatattva is connected with the Supreme Consciousness.
所以 Prabhupada 解释说，这 Mahatattva 物质能量实体与至尊的意识相通。
But Mahatattva is matter, it's material.
但是物质能量实体它是物质的。
And Prabhupada here also, he uses another term for Mahatattva. He describes it as the shadow of pure consciousness.
在这里说到 Prabhupada 用另一种方式解释了这个物质能量实体。他说它物质能量实体是这一纯粹意识的影子。
And the germinating place of all creation.
它是孕育整个创造的土壤。
So the creation begins from the Mahatattva.
所以这个创造是从 Mahatattva 这个物质能量实体当中产生出来的。
But the Mahatattva is described that it is pure goodness, but with a little bit of passion.
这里解释说，物质能量实体呢是纯粹善良属性，掺杂了一些物质知情属性的产物。
If it was pure goodness only, then it would be completely spiritual.
如果是只有纯粹善良属性的话，那它就是灵性的。
But because there's a little bit of passion, that is the cause of activity.
但是因为它掺杂了一些物质的属性，物质激情属性，这样活动便产生了。
There has to be that influence of passion to get activity, to get things going, to do things.
如果要让这个事情得以进展的话，必须会有一些物质激情属性的掺杂。
And that is why I was saying that with the Buddhism, there was no passion.There was no influence of passion, so everything stopped.
就比方说我解释过，在佛教当中，他们没有这种物质激情属性，所以他们的活动都停止了。
And nobody did anything.
他们什么都不做，什么活动都不做。
Everybody just meditation.
每个人就坐着冥想。
Nobody planted the fields, nobody grew food.
没有人去种地，也没有人去种水果。
This is why the Buddhist teaching was put out, was sent out of India.
这就是为什么这个佛教被逐出了印度。
Because it was stopping the development of the country.
因为它阻止了整个国家的发展。
The people have to work, they have to be engaged in proper activities.
人们必须要去工作，他们必须从事某种活动。
And everybody should be engaged according to their qualification.
每个人都必须根据各自的资格从事某些活动。
Some people are Brahminical by nature.
有的人天性是 Brahmana, 是婆罗门。
They have to study, they have to read, they have to worship the deities.
他们要研习经典和崇拜神像。
They have to perform these. They have to help people with education.
他们要给人们教育。
To teach the people.
他们要教育人们。
And then they have to have kshatriyas to organize and manage.
查水亚要组织和管理。
In our Krishna consciousness movement, there have to be people to organize everything.
在我们的 Krishna 自觉运动当中，需要有一些人来进行组织。
There has to be some kind of management structure.
必须有一些这个管理机构。
And in the universe, there's a management structure.
在这个整个宇宙当中都有一个管理的机构，管理的结构。
There's a supreme lord over everyone.
就是有一个至尊主，他主导着所有的人。
And he has his empowered assistants in the form of the demigods.
然后他还有这些被赋予了力量的半神人。
And we know that 330 million demigods.
我们有三千三百万的半神人。
And they're all helping in the administration of the universe.
他们都是在从事着对宇宙的管理工作。
And then you have the Vaishyas who are doing the food production.
Vaishyas 要种植农作物。
They're supposed to also take care of cows.
他们也要照顾奶牛。
Because the cows provide milk, which is so important.
因为奶牛会产生牛奶，而牛奶是非常重要的。
We have to have ghee to perform yagyas.
我们需要酥油来举行祭祀。
And we get ghee from milk.
我们只能从这个牛奶当中得到酥油。
So the cows are very important. They're taken care of by the Vaishyas.
所以奶牛是非常重要的，他们受到Vaishya们的保护。
And the Vaishya also have to grow the food.
Vaishya 也必须要种植食物。
And they do business, they will do all the different trading.
他们也会做生意，做各种贸易。
And then we have the worker, the laboring class, the Sudra.
劳工阶层，这个工薪阶层的人被称为Sudra。
So they also have an important part to play in the world.
他们在这个世界上也有重要的角色要扮演。
But they have to be properly instructed and taken care of.
但是呢，他们应该得到恰当的指导，并且受到保护。
So this is the arrangement of the Supreme Lord Krishna.
这是至尊主Krishna本人的安排。
In the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, Chatur Varnam Maya Shristam Guna Karma Vibhagasha. Krishna said, I created the four divisions of society.
Krishna在《薄伽梵歌》里面说到，是我创造了人类社会的四个阶层。
Just like we're hearing about the creation of the material world.
正如我们现在在这里聆听着物质世界的创造。
This is called Srishti Tattva. Srishti means the creation.
这被称为 Srishti Tattva. Srishti 的意思就是创造。
So Krishna said, Chatur Varnam Maya Shristam. I created the divisions of society.
所以 Krishna 说到，是我创造了这个社会当中这四个划分。
He didn't create everybody the same.
他并没有说每个人是一样的。
He created people according to their guna and karma.
他是根据人们的guna这个品质以及他们的 karma 这个业报进行了划分。
Guna is quality. Karma is activity.
Guna 的意思是属性。
So people have to be engaged according to their nature.
人们应该根据各自不同的本性从事活动。
And so that's why in the material world there are different activities.
这就是为什么在物质世界里有各种各样不同的活动。
It is all the arrangement of the Supreme Lord.
这一切都是至尊主的安排。
The Supreme Intelligent Being.
它是至尊的，有智慧的生物。
So we have consciousness, but there's a supreme consciousness.
我们都有知觉，但是呢，有一个至尊的知觉意识。
And this is stated in the Vedas.
这在伟大经中有所描述。
Nityo Nityanam Chaitananas Chaitananam. There's Nitya means eternal.
Nitya 的意思是永恒的。
And so say, amongst all eternal beings, there's one supreme eternal being.
在所有永恒的生物体当中，有一个至尊永恒的生物。
We are all eternal beings. We're all nitya. Our soul is eternal.
我们都是这个永恒的。我们都是 nitya. 这个灵魂是永恒的。
But there is one supreme eternal being.
但是有一位是至尊的永恒的生物。
And Chaitanya means consciousness.
Chaitanya 的意思是意识、知觉。
Just like Chaitanya.
就比如说 Chaitanya.
Right, pure conscious.
意思是纯粹的知觉。
So Nityo Nityanam Chaitananas Chaitananam. Amongst all conscious beings.There's one supreme conscious being.
在所有有知觉的生物体当中，有一位是至尊的有知觉的生物体。
And then the Vedas go on to say, "Eko Bahunam Yogadati Kama." That one supreme being is providing for the needs of everyone.
维达经中继续说到，那一位至尊永恒的生物体为其他所有的。生物体提供他们的所需。
He's providing, but it doesn't mean you just sit back and let him do everything.
他是在提供着一切，但是那不意味着你就可以躺平了，然后等待着一切自动到来。
Just like Krishna said to Arjuna, you know, well, Arjuna understood Krishna to be the supreme Lord, but still Arjuna had to fight.
就比如说这个阿朱娜，他虽然知道了 Krishna 是至尊主，但是他仍然要去作战。
Krishna is the doer. He is the cause of everything.
Krishna 是行动者，他是所有一切的原因。
But Arjuna had to do the work. He had to fight.
但是阿朱娜要去做这项工作，他要去作战。
Krishna told Arjuna, "Nimitta matra bhava savyasachi." Just become an instrument in my service.
Krishna 对阿朱娜说道，你只是成为为我做服务的工具。
Yeah. So our position is like that.
我们的地位就像这样。
We are instruments in the service of Krishna.
我们是为 Krishna 做服务的工具。
You can be a good instrument and you can be a bad instrument.
你可以成为一个好的工具，也可以成为一个不好的工具。
It's up to us how we want to work for Krishna.
这取决于我们在多大程度上愿意为 Krishna 工作。
So Krishna gives everyone an opportunity to engage in his service.
Krishna 给予每一个人机会，让他为 Krishna 从事服务。
And the material world is created.For this purpose.
物质世界就是为了这一目的而创造的。
But in bad consciousness, when our consciousness is not properly controlled, then we think the world is for my enjoyment.
但是呢，当我们的知觉状态没有处在一个好的状态的时候，没有受到控制的时候，我们就会认为物质世界是用来给我们享受的。
So our consciousness becomes covered.
这样我们的知觉就被覆盖了。
Just like we were on Sankirtan yesterday.
就比如说我们昨天晚上在 Sankirtan.
昨天早上
我们 Sankirtan.
We were outside.
我们来到大街上。
And the weather was very nice and the sky was clear.
当时这个天气非常好的，天空也很晴朗。
But then suddenly it became very dark.
但是突然的就来了一团云
The sun became covered.
这个太阳就被遮住了
And that heavy rain came.
然后就下了一场暴雨
And so we were lucky of course there was a nice place for us to go and shelter.
当然我们非常的幸运有一个地方能够让我们避雨
And the rain cooled everything down.The rain cooled down the atmosphere.
然后这个雨呢，就让这个变得清凉起来。
And we could enjoy the Sankirtan more.
然后我们就可以更好的这个唱诵 Sankirtan.
But the cloud came and covered the sun.
但是这个云它出现，然后遮住了太阳。
In the same way, our consciousness becomes covered.
同样的，我们的知觉有时也会被覆盖。
Our pure consciousness is to understand I am the servant of Krishna.
纯粹的知觉是什么呢？纯粹的知觉是我知道我自己是 Krishna 的仆人。
But when the consciousness becomes covered, we forget Krishna.
但是当知觉被覆盖的时候，我们便遗忘了 Krishna。
Krishna Bhuya Jeev Anadir Bahir Mukha. We forget Krishna. When consciousness is covered, we forget Krishna.
我们忘记了 Krishna. 当我们的知觉被覆盖的时候，我们便会遗忘 Krishna.
And we look at everything and think for my enjoyment.
然后我们看着周遭的事物，就会认为那是用来给我享受的。
We think, I will enjoy, this is for me, this is mine.
我会想啊，这是我的，属于我的。
But the devotee will think, this is Krishna's, I have to give to Krishna.
但是 Krishna, 但是奉献者们会想，这是属于 Krishna 的，我应该给 Krishna。
In the material world, the man has, if he gets some flowers, he will give them to his wife or his girlfriend.
在物质世界里，如果一个男人得到一朵鲜花的话，他会把这个鲜花给他的妻子或者情人。
But the devotee gets the flowers, they bring them for Krishna.
但是奉献者如果得到一朵鲜花，他会把这个鲜花献给 Krishna.
We told you the money is laying in the street. Money is laying on the street.
对，比如说这个地上有一个钱。
在路上看到一张
钱，
在路上看到一个钱。
So the Dhyani thinks Maya.
Dhyani 会想啊，那是 Maya.
Don't touch it.
不要触碰它。
Get in Maya.
那是 Maya.
And the Karmi thinks, oh, money, I will enjoy.
然后卡米这个果报。活动者呢，他们就会认为啊、哦，钱能给我享受吧。
And the devotee sees money. Oh, Krishna's money! You bring it. You put it in the box for Krishna.
然后奉献者看到那个钱呢，就会说哦，那是 Krishna 的钱。然后他就会把那个钱拿上，放到这个庙宇的盒子里。
That is pure consciousness.
那就是纯粹的知觉。
Right? We want to practice that kind of thinking.
我们要。这个练习这种思维方式。
We have a practical philosophy.
我们有这个非常实用的哲学。
Other people, they speak philosophy, they do different things.
有一些人呢，他们口里说着一套哲学，行为上却是另一套。
They say, oh, the world is not real.
他们说这个世界不是真实的。
But they enjoy like anything.
但是呢，他们却非常的享受这个世界。
They try to enjoy.
他们试图去享受。
So we say the world is real, but it is temporary.
但是我们说这个世界，是真实的，但只是短暂的。
We have to use it carefully.
所以我们要小心的运用它。
We don't want to waste.
我们不想浪费。
Everything is Krishna's property.
所有的一切都是 Krishna 的财产。
Use it in his service.
要把它们用来服务 Krishna.
We get a building, somebody gives us a building, a property, we'll use it for Krishna's service.
有的时候呢，人们会给予我们一栋楼、一些资产，然后我们就会把这些资产用来服务于 Krishna.
Somebody gives us some land.We'll use it to grow flowers and vegetables for Krishna.
有的时候，人们给我一片土地，我们就用这个土地来种植鲜花和蔬菜给 Krishna.
And we can also grow tulsi.
我们也可以种植 tulsi.
And you can even use the land to build a temple.
甚至可以用这块地来建造一座庙宇。
Everything should be used for Krishna's service.
所有的一切都可以用在对 Krishna 的服务当中。
Here in Malaysia, people have cars.
在马来西亚，人们都有车。
There's very poor. The public transport is not very good.
但是这个公共交通并不是很好。
Not many buses, not many trains.
没有很多的这个公交，没有很多的这个火车。
Some people have cars.
人们都有车。
And sometimes people give cars to our temple.
有的时候人们就会给我们的庙宇捐赠这个车。
They say, yeah, I don't need this car anymore, you can take it.
然后他们说呢，我不需要这些车了，你们可以用。
So we use it for Krishna.
所以我们就把这些车用来服务 Krishna。
Make use of everything for Krishna's service.
所以我们就像这样来，恰当的、充分的利用所有的一切。
And,
用在对 Krishna 的服务中。
And we try to engage people also in Krishna's service.
我们也让人们来从事对 Krishna 的服务。
People come to temple, they have nothing to do, we give them some engagement.
人们来到庙宇，然后他们没有什么事情可做，我们就会给他们一些服务做。
Somebody is going out collecting flowers and making flower garlands.
有一些人呢出去这个采购花，然后制作花环。
Somebody else helps to cut the vegetables.
有一些人在厨房里帮助切蔬菜。
There's always so much service to be done.
总是有很多的服务要去做。
We have a big temple, a big building here.
我们在这里有这么大的一栋楼，有这么大的一个庙宇。
I have to clean it regularly.
我们也要每天的清洁。
We need people, we need volunteers.
我们需要一些志愿者。
Right? We're always eager to get volunteers.
我们总是需要这些一些志愿者来做服务。
Come and what we call it, 义工。
义工在中国被称为义工。
Come and do voluntary service for Krishna.
就是为 Krishna 做一些自愿的服务。
And by serving Krishna in that way, people get spiritual benefit.
通过以这样的方式来服务 Krishna 呢，人们就会得到灵性的益处。
They get nice prasada.
得到好的 prasada.
Nice association.
得到好的黏液。
And they get purification.
他们就会得到净化。
So that is the real mercy of Krishna.
这是 Krishna 真正的仁慈。
So the material world is created like this that we can use the world for Krishna.
所以物质的世界创造出来就是以这样的方式，就是像这样子的，以便让我们利用这些物质的东西来服务 Krishna.
And that is the pure consciousness.
那就是纯粹的知觉状态。
All right, are there any questions?
大家有没有什么问题？
Anything? Charu Chetramantaji.
Good day, 刚才在讲课中提到我们的知觉有的时候会被覆盖，那个时候我们就会忘记 Krishna。我们学了经典也知道，我们是灵魂，不是这个躯体，有这个意识，但有的时候，会记着 Krishna， 记着我是灵魂，我是要做好的工具。但有的时候，由于某种影响，我们就会。被覆盖，有的时候覆盖的轻，有的时候覆盖的重，那时候我们就会，那个时刻就忘了 Krishna， 怎么才能时时刻刻的，永恒的记着 Krishna， 不忘记 Krishna， 好的 Krishna。
You mentioned that sometimes our consciousness will be covered.So when the consciousness be covered, we will forget Krishna. Sometimes we read from the scriptures that we know we are not the body, we are the soul. But sometimes the consciousness is slightly covered, sometimes heavily covered. We often forget Krishna. So my question is that how can we remember Krishna at any time, all the time?
Yeah, we can give the example just like sometimes you get a bump on the head and you lose your memory.
这有的时候比方说有一个例子就是说如果你得了失忆症就是你就会丧失所有的记忆。
We have this one devotee in Hong Kong. She was in a very bad accident.
就是在香港有一个奉献者，他就是出了一件很严重的事件。
She was in a coma for a month.
他就是得这个失忆症一个月，出了一个意外，就得这个失忆症一个月。
Somehow, you know, Krishna saved her and she came out of the coma, but she couldn't remember anything.
就是哦，就但是呢 ，Krishna 也保护了她。就当她从这个昏迷状态中醒来的时候，但是她就是什么都不记得了。
So, how did she get her memory back?
那她怎么才能恢复这个记忆呢
？She had to be introduced to everyone.
对他应该就是受到其他人的给他的介绍，其他人介绍。
This is your husband.
这是你的丈夫。
Anyway, she introduced everybody and gradually took her home. And you know, this is your home, and this is your, these are your clothes.
然后呢他就是其他人就这样给他介绍这是你的家这是你的衣服。
So, with devotees, it's the same thing. We come to the temple and we see the deity.
同样的事情对奉献人来说也是一样的。当我们来到这个庙宇见到神像。
And we hear from the devotees.
我们从奉献者那里聆听。
Krishna is the supreme, we are his servant.
我们聆听到 Krishna 是至尊，我们是他的仆人。
And we have to hear again and again.
我们要一遍又一遍的聆听。
We have to be reminded.
我们要时刻的受到提醒。
And gradually we start to remember.
逐渐的，你的这个记忆就开始恢复了，就开始记起来了。
Because we've been in the material world a very long time.
因为我们在物质世界里。很长很长的时间
so we've forgotten
我们遗忘了
our whole consciousness has become covered
我们的整个知觉意识都被覆盖
how can we remember we're Krishna's servant we're not the body
我们如何能够总是记着我们是 Krishna 的仆人我们不是这个身体呢
have to hear
我们要聆听通过聆听
just like we were talking aboutOne of our devotees, he wants to do the Bhakti Shastri exam.
有一次，有一个奉献者要做这个巴提沙斯水的考试。
But he doesn't read.
但是他没有读。
And you know, they only do the course. They have English and they have Tamil.
因为他们那一课程是用英文和泰米尔语讲出
的。But here in Malaysia, the language is Bahasa.
在马来西亚这里，他们的语言被称为巴萨。
So we don't have any books in Bahasa.
我们没有任何这个巴萨语言的书籍。
So difficult.
所以很困难。
But you know, supposed to do the Bhakti Shastri course to get second initiation.
但是呢，你要必须要学习和通过这个巴提沙水的课程，才能得到二十七地。
So how?He has to learn slokas.
他们要学习 sloka 诗节。
So how to memorize the sloka?
如何背诵这些 sloka 诗节呢
？You have to hear it. You have to hear it again and again and again.
你要一遍一遍又一遍的反复的聆听。
You know, the rest means you repeat the verse again and again and again. You start to remember it.
这意味着你要一遍又一遍的反复的阅读这些诗节之后，你才能够记住它们。
Just like every morning we sing the Guru Vastika.
就比方说，我们每天早上唱这个巴颂名诗。
And so in the beginning.What is this? You know, we cannot understand anything. What it means?
在刚开始的时候，我们不知道它是什么意思，我们什么都理解不了。
And the words are not very strange. You know how to read it. It's not anything we can read so easily.
这个词汇也看起来很奇怪，我们就没有办法很轻松地念出来。
But you hear it, and every day you sing it, every day you hear it, you hear it, you start to remember it.
但是呢，你每天每天的在聆听，每天每天的在唱诵，逐渐的你就开始记住了。
So the same way we have to hear these things that we're not the body, that we're Krishna's servant.
所以同样的道理，我们要反复的聆听这些话语，我们。是 Krishna 的仆人，我们不是这个身体。
Gradually we start to remember.
逐渐的，我们就开始记起来了。
So it just requires hearing.
所以只是需要聆听。
You want to learn the slokas, you have to hear. You have to hear them.
如果你要学习斯洛卡师姐的话，你要先聆听他们，聆听。
You hear the word again and again and again.
那里面的词汇你要一遍又一遍的聆听。
Just like you go to school, you learn to read the Chinese letters.
比方说你去上学的时候，你学那个中文的字母。
我、你、他。Right? And you learn to read these things, you start to remember.
所以你就你读像这样去读，然后之后呢，你就记住了。
So we have to practice hearing our spiritual position.
所以我们要练习去聆听有关于我们灵性的地位的一切。
Krishna consciousness, love of Krishna is in everyone.
Krishna 知觉就对 Krishna 的爱已经在每个人的心中。
But You have to hear to awaken that love for Krishna.
但是呢，你要通过聆听来唤醒那对 Krishna 的爱。
So you have to, we have to hear. Remember, we've been in the material world for a very long time. We're eternally conditioned souls.
所以我们要聆听，要记得我们已经在这个物质世界里已经很长的时间了。我们是永恒受制约的灵魂。
But we can be changed.
但是我们可以发生改变。
Just hear very carefully.
只是通过非常仔细的聆听。
And then consciousness will come.
这个知觉就会恢复。
We have to practice wherever the mind wanders. When we start to think the body, bring it back.
所以我们要练习，一旦这个心意飘走了，然后我们开始想这个物质身体的时候呢，我们就要把它收回来。
In the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna tells Arjuna, the mind is restless and unsteady.
在《薄伽梵歌》中，阿朱那对 Krishna 说到，这个心意是躁动不安的。
We have to practice bringing the mind back.
所以我们要练习把这个心意收摄回来。
It's going to take some time.
这需要花一些时间。
But if we have to do the practice.
但是呢，我们自己要去做这个练习。
Just like Janaka's practicing playing the harmonium.
就比方说，这个Janaka Babu在练习弹韩木里琴。
You can hear every day he's playing the harmonium.
你可以看到他每天都在弹韩木里。
Practicing.
他是在练习。
The same way we have to practice.
同样的，我们也要练习。
We want to play Madanga good. You have to practice.
如果你要想把这个 Madanga 演奏得很好的话，你要反复的练习。
So we have to practice hearing about Krishna.
所以我们也要练习来聆听有关 Krishna 的一切。
We have to practice chanting his name.
要练习来唱诵他的圣名。
And we have to practice serving Krishna.
练习来服务 Krishna.
One day we'll get the chance to go and be with Krishna.
终有一天我们会得到机会，去和 Krishna 在一起。
Okay. Any other question?
其他的问题
？Yes, Prabhu.
Thank you, Maharaj. This question is not really related to today's topic. I is just sharing my experience, my journey. I see that finding a particular path is like learning. It's like finding which musical instrument to play, which whether the person should be a violinist, whether he should play the mandanga, and so on. So the question is, how does a person, when he searches, when he is a truth seeker, how does he finally find a path that suits him? So to ask a violinist to play the piano is not, I don't think it's good advice, but the point is, how does the violinist find his path that he is called to play to be a violinist, and how does a pianist, for example, finds that piano is his instrument? So essentially, my question is, how does one find the path of his spiritual? How does one find one's spiritual path? Whether it's Christianity, whether it's Muslim, whether it's Hinduism, and then within Hinduism, whether it's Krishna consciousness, and so on. So it's a kind of a general question, I'm not sure.
印度教还有我们的 Krishna 之觉，所以如何找到自己的道路，这是一个普遍的问题。
Yeah. Well, we need also mercy.
我们也需要仁慈。
There's the mercy of the devotee.
要需要奉献者的仁慈。
Which ultimately brings people to Krishna consciousness.
而是这仁慈呢，最终使人们，把人们带入到库什纳自觉当中。
But in the material world, as you say, Prabhu was giving the example: someone plays piano and someone else plays the violin.
就比方说，帕布刚才举了一个例子，在这个物质世界里，有的人呢他是拉小提琴的，而有的人呢是弹钢琴的。
How does he know that he's meant to play the piano and not the violin?
那一个人如何才能知道他应该是弹钢琴而不是弹这个小提琴呢？
So he was compared. How do we know I'm meant to be Krishna conscious and I'm not meant to be a Christian or what?
所以他就以这样做了一个例子来比喻，就一个人如何才能知道他应该是修 Krishna 自觉，而不是。做一个基督教徒。
Of course, Krishna consciousness is not against any other religion.
当然 ，Krishna 自觉是不反对任何其他宗教的。
People can these different religions are according to their birth.
这个不同的宗教信仰是根据他们的这个出生。
By birth, somebody becomes a Christian.
就是他们有些人，他们一出生生来就是基督教徒。
Born in a Christian country.
他们出生在一个基督教的国家里。
Somebody else is born in an Islamic country. Muslim.
有的人呢，他是出生在这个伊斯兰教的穆斯林家庭。
But that birth also is not by chance.
但是这个出生也不是偶然发生的。
But it's because of our previous life.
而是跟我们过去的生死有关。
That we had a particular nature, we had a karma, we had qualities which brought us to take that birth.
这是因为我们有特定的这个品性，有过去的这种业报，使我们在那一种处境当中出生。
And that's why, like some Hindu temples, they won't let Westerners into their temple.
那就是为什么在印度的一些庙宇里面，他们是不允许西方人进入的。
Not only Westerners, they won't let non-Hindus into their temple.
他们不仅不允许西方人进入，就是非印度教徒，他们都不允许进入。
Because they say you don't have the birth, you don't have the qualification.
因为他们说你不是出生在这个传统当中，你没有资格。
They say next lifetime you can come.
他们说你下一辈子再来吧。
So we take birth according to our past activities.
所以我们是根据我们过去的行为结果而得到出生的。
And we associate with the modes of nature.
根据我们与物质自然属性的接触。
So somebody is associating more with the mode of goodness.
有些人呢与善良属性有更多的联系。
Right, they may play the piano.
他们可能会是弹钢琴的。
And somebody else may be more in the mode of passion.
有的人呢可能是更多的处在激情属性当中。
And plays the guitar. Play guitar.
他们就会弹吉他。
And somebody is more in the mode of ignorance.
有的人呢是处在愚昧属性当中。
They don't play anything.
他们什么都不弹，就什么都不做。
They're just lazy.
只是很懒惰。
So association with the modes of nature causes us to move in particular paths.According to how we associate with the material nature, we will act in that way.
就是根据我们与不同的物质自然属性的联系，然后我们就会有不同的行为方式。
When we act in the mode of ignorance, then we will cultivate the activities in association with that mode of ignorance.
当我们这个受到愚昧属性的影响的时候呢，我们就会从事一些跟愚昧属性有关的活动。
Lazy, dirty.
比如说很懒惰，很脏。
Intoxicated.
麻醉。
And one can also take up a religion which is more influenced by the mode of ignorance.
一个人呢可能会接受某种受到愚昧属性。
Like where they're slaughtering animals.
比方说屠杀动物。
And sometimes even they have temples where there is human sacrifice.
有些地方甚至有一些庙宇在做那个人的祭祀。
They will kill people.
他们在那里杀人。
And sacrifice them as a sacrifice, right?
就是来做这样的一种祭祀。
Offer the human life.
我就是把人类的生命给献祭出去。
So that's the mode of ignorance.
那是愚昧属性的。
And then the mode of passion, people have some religious belief, but they want to get something, they want to get a lot of benefit from it.
而在激情属性当中呢，人们也许会有一些宗教信仰，但是呢，他们想从这种信仰当中得到某些好处。
We should make a lot of money.
他们想得到很多的钱。
Get a lot of fame.
得到很多的名声。
They have this kind of ambition.
是，他们有这种就是有这种追求。
Yeah. And the mode of goodness, then people are more.Thinking about knowledge and being happy and peaceful.
但是在善良属性的人们呢，他们是非常快乐的，他们非常平和。
They just simply they want to live and maybe clean, be very clean and pure.
他们要这个保持纯洁，保持洁净。
And so, according everything is depending on how we connect with this material nature.
所以这一切都是，都在于我们是如何与物质自然接触的。
And we connect with the material nature according to our past activities.
而这个我们过去的行为的这个反应，会就是影响我们与这个物质自然属性接触的方式。
Somebody may be born in a family where everyone's a musician.
有些人可能一出生他就出生在一个音乐的世家。
Right. Maybe somebody's playing the piano, somebody else is playing the violin.
也许有的人在演奏钢琴，有的人在演奏小提琴。
They're in the same family.
但他们可能就是来自同一个家族。
But what kind of music are they playing?
他们就是他们演奏的一种乐器。
Right, there's classical music.
有古典的音乐。
And there's modern music.
也有现代的音乐。
And then you have traditional folk music.
还有这种传统的民谣音乐。
We were in Kuching, and Kripa Sindhu Prabhu arranged very nice program there.
当我们在Kuching的时候，这个奎帕辛杜帕布在那里安排了很好的节目。
They had these people dancing who were all.He told me that sometimes these people, they dance for the sultans. When the sultans have special guests, special program, they bring this troupe of dancers to perform.
就是那些跳舞，他们邀请了一些跳舞的人，就是他们说这些跳舞的人只是说就是邀请贵宾来的时候他们才跳舞。
因为在马来西亚有一些Sultan, 我们叫他们 Sultan, 他们的地位好像一个国王一样 Sultan,
就是马来西亚里面有这个 so, 我们称之为 Sultan, 他们的地位很高，就像国王一样。
Yeah, the Malaysia, there are different states.
马来西亚有不同的州。
Just like in China, you have different states, right?
Province,
yeah.
就比方说，在中国有不同的省份。
You may know, you have Heilongjiang, you have Liaoyang, you have Gansu, like that, you know. Hubei, Nanbei, Hunan, Hunan, like that. These places, like.So these are provinces, right?
Yes.
Hubei, Hunan. 省。是。Hubei 省。是。对。省份。省。So in Malaysia also, there's some different states.
所以同样的呢，在马来西亚有不同的州。
And each of the states, they have a ruler.
每一个州呢，都有一个管理者。
It doesn't have any power.
它是没有什么这种复权的
because there's a government now.
因为现在是属于政府的。
But in the past, they were very powerful.
但是在过去的时候，他们是有很大的这种力量的。
And they still have a lot of money.
他们也有很多的钱。
And you will often see big billboards, pictures of them.
你们会看到就是。有很大很大的广告牌，上面印着他们的像。
And what did they put there? What is it? Dalat. 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 It means God save the king, huh? God save the king. They have a big billboard, and they put it in the local language, in the Bahasa language. God save the king.
所以他们就有一个很大的广告牌，然后上面用他们当地的巴西的语言写着这个神。拯救了国王。
Yeah, he's represented in the Bhagavad Gita. Krishna said, "Among men, I am the monarch." So the monarch, the ruler, they represent Krishna.
Krishna 在《薄伽梵歌》里面说到，在人类之中，我是帝皇。所以呢，这个国王他是 Krishna 的代表。
So Malaysia, they have these different sultans, the rulers, And you know, they take birth in these families. You know, they must have had a lot of piety from the past.
所以同样的，在马来西亚呢，就有很多这种州长啊，这些管理者。那么他们出生在这种家庭当中，肯定就是因为他们过去从事过很多的虔诚活动。
You don't become the king so easily.
你是不可能那么容易就成为国王的。
You can be a politician, you can become even the prime minister, but you know, that doesn't last very long.
你也许会成为一个政治家，也许会成为一个大臣，但是不会持续很长时间。
But the Sultan, he's the king for life.
但是他们这种国王呢，他是终身都是有这个地位的。
So that they have some power.
所以他们拥有一些权力。
But that power is given to them by the grace of Krishna.
但是他们的这些力量，他们的这些权力是由 Krishna 给予他们的。
So we want to understand everything as through the modes of the material nature.
我们要知道，所有的一切都是通过物质自然属性来运作的。
And somebody is the mode of goodness, somebody is the mode of passion, somebody is the mode of ignorance.
有的人在善良属性当中，有的人在激情属性当中，有的人在愚昧属性当中。
And that's how people act.
这就是为什么这个人们不同的行为方式，他们是以这样的方式行为。
They're being controlled by the different modes.
他们受到不同物质自然属性的控制。
But above the modes is Krishna.
但是在所有这些物质属性之外，是上呢是 Krishna.
And if we get the mercy of the devotee, it can get us out of the modes.
而如果我们能够得到奉献者的仁慈的话，我们就可以摆脱这些物质属性的影响。
So that's what we want to give more mercy to people, get them out of the modes of nature.
所以这就是为什么我们要给予仁慈，让人们这个从物质自然属性当中出来。
But not everybody wants to come out.
但是呢，并不是每一个人都想这个接受。
I'm happy here.
他们会说，哦，我在这里很快乐呀。
Yeah, I'm in the mode of ignorance.
我现在在善良属性当中。
I have my marijuana, I have my drugs, you know.
Marijuana.
What is that?
Yeah, the smoke.
Dupin. Dupin. Dupin.
Drugs. Heroin.
Oh, yeah. 有些人就是他们在这里吃那个毒品和海洛因，他们觉得很快乐。
I have my beer.
我有啤酒。
I have my cigarettes.
我有烟可以抽。
I have volume of television.
我有电视可以看。
I'm happy.
我很快乐呀。
They're enjoying the modes of nature.
他们就是这样通过物质自然属性在享受。
And somebody else is enjoying playing the violin.
有的人他是通过这个演奏，钢琴啊，演奏乐器来享受。
So Kripasindu, he brought these people to dance at the temple, and they were doing this cultural, the traditional dance from this country, from Malaysia.
所以这个喀巴辛度跑步呢，就把这些人请来在那里跳舞，就那些人就演奏了这个马来西亚传统的这种古典舞蹈。
These people, they often dance for the kings, for the sultans here in Malaysia.
有的时候那些人呢，就是有的时候会为这个马来西亚这边的一些领袖啊，一些就是国王级的那些。地位很高的人物为他们来跳舞的。
So somebody is dancing the traditional dance, the ancient dance here of Malaysia.
他们这些人呢就在跳这个马来西亚传统的这个舞蹈。
And somebody else is doing modern dancing.
其实有一些人呢是跳现代的舞蹈。
And we have our dancing.
我们也表演我们的舞蹈。
Our dancing is for Krishna.
我们的舞蹈是为 Krishna 而跳的。
And our dancing is transcendental.
我们的舞蹈是超然的。
Other people, they're dancing, you know, they're presenting some culture.
其他人的舞蹈，比方说他们是表演一些文化节目。
Some material culture.
那是物质的文化。
But our culture is spiritual.
而我们的文化是灵性的。
So it's by association. Everything comes by association.
所以这些都是通过联谊，所有的一切都是通过联谊发生的。
You're born into a family who's playing the violin. You'll also play the violin.
你出生在一个这个演奏小提琴的这个家族里面，那你也会演奏小提琴。
Why would you be born in a family playing the violin? Because in the past life you wanted to play the violin.
你为什么会出生在一个演奏小提琴的家族里面呢？是因为你在过去生世当中的时候，你想要演奏那个小提琴。
There was a famous sitarist, Ravi Shankar. Sitar is a very difficult instrument to play.
这个西塔这种琴是很难演奏的一种乐器。
You know, they play. Have you seen that instrument, sitar?
Sitar.
Sitar. It's a special stringed instrument and very difficult to play. You have to practice for many years.
所以这是一种非常难以演奏的乐器，你要练习好多年份。
So there was a famous.He must be dead now, but he was very famous, an Indian man named Ravi Shankar. He played sitar and was very famous. When he would play, thousands of people would come. They all wanted to hear him play the sitar.
在印度有一个人叫 Ravi Shankar, 这个人呢，他是非常擅长演奏这种很难演奏的这种乐器 sitar.就是当他来演奏的时候呢，就会有成千上万的人来观看他的表演。
So it said he took birth 9 times to play the sitar. 9 lives he come. He took birth after birth, 9 times every time play the sitar.
据说呢，他是出生了9次，就是在9个生世当中，他都在演奏这种名为 sitar 的这种乐器。
That's what you get.
这就是他的愿望。
You have that desire.
所以你也应该有你的愿望。
Come back again and again.
他一次又一次的来，一次又一次的来。
And play sitar.
他就在这个9个生世当中，他每一个生世都在演奏这种乐器。
And other people, they're artists, they paint.
有的人呢，他们是艺术家，他们很会绘画。
Been painting sometimes for lifetimes, many lives.
有的时候他们终其一生都会去画画。
Sometimes you get little children, they just come to the piano and they can begin to play the piano.
有的时候呢，就有一些小孩子，如果你把他带到这个钢琴。旁边的时候，他就会跑到那个钢琴那里自己弹奏起来。
Nobody taught them.
没有人教过他们。
From the previous life.
从他们上一世的时候。
Previous life, they played the piano.
他们在上一世的时候就开始弹奏钢琴了。
Next life, they come again. They can play. They remember.
所以在下一世的时候呢，当他再次投生的时候，他仍然记得。
That is not the goal of life.
但那不是生命的目标。
They remain in the material world.
那会使我们停留在物质世界里。
Take birth and die.
又一次的出生和死亡。
And then take birth again and then die.
又一次的出生，然后又一次的死亡。
Just like people study Chinese culture.
比方说，有的人在学习中国文化。
Again and again and again.
他们一遍又一遍地学习中国文化。
Stay in the material world.
就像这样停留在物质世界里。
That is not the goal.
那不是我们的目标。
We have to get out of the material.
我们要离开这个物质世界。
Why?
为什么呢？
Because it's very dangerous.
因为这是一个非常危险的地方。
You may not always get the human birth.
你可能并不总是能够得到人体的生命。
Now you have the human body.
现在你们得到人体生命。
But we don't know next life.
但是我们不知道下一生是会如何。
What will happen?
下一世会发生什么呢？
There was one man, he became the prime minister of a great country.
有一个人呢，他就成为了一个很大的国家的一个大臣。
成为国家的总统。
哦，总统 ，OK。
And so he died, and the astrologers predicted where did he go next time.
然后他就有一天死掉了，然后这个占星家呢就就占星，然后看看他下一生是去了哪里。
They said, "Oh, he has become a dog."
他们说那个人就下一世变成了狗。
In Sweden.
变成了瑞典的一只狗。
在 Sweden.
Sweden.
一个地方。
Rodden. Rodden. She said Rodden.
瑞典哈。
Rodden. Time up.
Time up.